And I would like to ask one of the person that hasn't been here for a while, but I am with him in another forum of intercession, and that is Sandile. Sandile, would you open for us in a word of prayer on this prayer meeting for tonight? And welcome and greet the house.
Thank you, Bishop, and a very warm welcome to everyone. Can we close our eyes and bow our hearts, please? Father, in the name of Jesus Christ, our Lord and Savior, we come before you with great joy and excitement, counting it such a privilege and an honor to come into agreement with your heart, Father. Such a privilege, Father, to engage heaven, Lord, on the solutions for this earth. We thank you, Lord, for releasing your heavenly strategies, Lord, on prayer this evening. We thank you, Lord, for what you're doing in our land, in our nations, in the hearts of your people, Lord. We thank you for the presence of your Spirit on this platform. We thank you, Lord, for your work in our hearts and in the work of your people. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen.
Amen and amen. Thank you so much, Sandile, for that powerful prayer, and the Lord has heard us. And I was still waiting for Naomi. I'm not able to see her, but she will join us. I know it's just some kind of network situation, but the Lord will sort it out. She will soon get to together with us. And in the interest of time, allow me to please bring to our meeting this evening Dr. Apostle Roland Msiska to take us on. He has been actually teaching on this platform for quite a while long now, and the Lord has been speaking through him on very, very important revelation that each and every one of us would like to hear. And so to give him ample time to bring forth what the Lord has printed into his heart, shall we please welcome Dr. Msiska. You're welcome, sir, and the Lord bless.
God bless you also, Bishop, and thank you very much for the privilege of sharing together this evening. If there is an area in our lives where we really indeed need, as children of God, to produce multiple restraining orders, it's in the area of politics. It is called that this is an area that is considered a dirty area, but I think it is a very serious mistake we have made, and I think we should start by repenting, because there is no area this side of eternity where the Lord Jesus Christ is not Lord of the universe. So I'll draw your attention to Acts 13, and what we'll be looking at is the use of restraining orders, or to use the Zambian language, injunctions against the enemies of the kingdom. So turn with me to Acts 13, which is where we will be meditating. Now, you will notice that the Barnabas and Paul were sent out by the Holy Spirit. And I think it is important to start by saying the one who has been left this side of eternity to help us to do the work of the Lord is the Holy Spirit. So one condition is that we find ourselves sent out by the Lord, by the Holy Spirit himself in our various areas of work. The second thing you will notice is the fact that the Apostle Paul and Barnabas were completely aligned to the work of God. So you see in verse 5, it says, when they arrived in Salamis, they preached the word of God in the synagogues of the Jews. And if you remember, our Lord Jesus Christ gave us the instruction that wherever we are, in whatever mountain we are, the issue is to preach the word of God. But immediately as they were going around, they came across a sorcerer. They found a certain sorcerer, a false prophet, a Jew whose name is Bar Jesus. But let me define, according to the dictionary, who a sorcerer is, so that we understand that these individuals are still around our politician. A sorcerer is a person who uses power gained from the assistant or control of evil spirits, especially for divining and necromancing or speaking to the dead. And I can tell you, we'll be making a serious mistake if we think things have changed. If anything, there is more now around our leaders in this particular area. So when they had gone through the island of Panthos, they found this sorcerer who is a false prophet and a Jew whose name was Bar Jesus, basically like son of Jesus. This is very interesting. Now that we have known who the sorcerer was, who was the politician? If you turn with me to verse 7, and by the way, if you go to the Old Testament, whether you are dealing with Babylon or Egypt, you'll find that around the leaders, there were always these individuals. So who was the politician who this sorcerer was sitting around? He says it was a proconsul or a governor in a province in ancient Rome, having the authority, much higher authority than the council. And this man was called Sergius Paras, and the Holy Spirit describes him as an intelligent man. So he may have heard that there were some things happening around, so he requested for Barnabas and Paul and sought to hear the word of God. Now, this is very important. And so you can see immediately that the enemy's plan kicks in. What happens? Although we are not given details, but in verse 8, we are told, but the Eremus, the sorcerer, for so his name was translated, withstood them. In other words, decided to issue a negative restraining order. A restraining order from the kingdom of darkness. Why do I say this? Because it says seeking to turn from the proconsul from the faith. So many of us have had this experience. You are in the presence of a politician and you are trying to share the word of God. Suddenly something interrupts, or in certain cases, if you are lucky, they leave. In certain cases, they just do not listen. But in this particular case, we are told that this man stood to fight them. And why was he fighting them? Because they were the proclaimers of the good news, because they were bringing the presence of God in this governance area, which is extremely important. Now, I am sure you may be wondering if you think about it, and some of us who have friends who are politicians who are not saved, you will realize that many of them spend a lot of money to go to diviners, to sangomas, to achieve whatever they want to achieve. Now, once we have understood that these sorcerers, these wizards, these witches, these diviners use evil spirits to carry out their task, to blindfold the politicians so that they do not come to the knowledge of our Lord Jesus Christ, then we can go a step further. Because this is a spiritual matter, the question we should ask ourselves, who discovered the plan of the enemy? Verse 9. Then Saul, who is called Paul, filled with the Holy Spirit. Now we know that the Apostle Paul had been filled with the Holy Spirit before. Now looked at intently at him. Now what this means, he was enabled by the Holy Spirit, empowered by the Holy Spirit to discern that something else was happening in this situation. So really, it is the Holy Spirit that discovered that the enemy was trying to withstand the Apostle Paul and Barnabas. Mm-hmm. Now, we need to understand that this man is an advisor, is a person that gives advice to this politician. So you can imagine what this means. It essentially means this is a conveyor of the kingdom of darkness presence in the leader's offices. Now, I want you to see exactly what happens. As soon as the Apostle Paul is empowered and enabled, and he sees what is going on, he stands out very boldly and turns to this advisor of Sergius and says, "Oh, fool of deceit." Now we know that some of our advisors around our leaders are liars. They are filled with fraud. They, as it is said, they are sons of the devil, enemies of righteousness, who pervert, who look for every way to pervert the straight ways of the Lord. And because the area of politics is so important, that is what is channeled right through the mechanisms of the enemy wants to do. No, nobody of us can argue that there is a lot of deceit, there is a lot of fraud, there is a lot of lying among his politicians. But now here we see what drives this particular process. And the apostles use a very strong language. You are the son of the devil, the enemy of righteousness. Will you not cease perverting the straight ways of the Lord? Now, immediately, he issues what I would call a restraining order. If you understand that is a restraining order, is an order from heaven to stop the enemy to divert the purposes, the destiny of a nation. This is what the apostle says. And now, indeed, the hand of the Lord is upon him. In other words, this restraining order is put into effect by the Lord. And now notice how specific the Apostle Paul is. He says, "You shall be blind, not seeing the sun for a time." Now, that for a time just shows you the mercy of God. And the Bible tells us immediately a dark mist fell on him and he went around seeking someone to lead him. So we can see clearly the content of this retaining order. It is very specific. It is time bound, and the effect was immediate. What were the results of this restraining order? Number one, this advisor got blind. Number two, the proconsul believed when he saw what had been done, being astonished at the teaching of the Lord. Is this not the time, dear brothers and sisters, that even as we go in the field and declare the word of God, we should be able to generate the kinds of things that we have seen in this particular situation? So, how do we apply this teaching to our situation? Now, the situation that we have here, let's begin by first in order for us to be able to respond and carry out what the Apostle Paul carried out and Barnabas, we must first recognize our authority in Christ. I can assure you, brethren, that in my experience, when I have been about doing the business of the Lord, any demon that has attempted to interfere with that, the Lord has dealt with that almost immediately. So we begin by recognizing our authority in Christ. Psalm 149, 5 to 9. Let this be joyful in glory. Let them sing aloud on their beds. Let the high praises of God be in their, now notice this, and a two-edged sword in their hand. What to do what? To execute vengeance on the nations, punishments on the people. Now look at this. To bind their kings with chains and their nobles with fetters of iron. That is individuals that stand in the way. Here is what is declared to them. And listen to this. To execute on them the written judgment, this one I have always sensed. Praise the Lord. So what it means essentially, when we are in the field and the situation arises, we will remember that there are scriptures that are very specific for certain situations. There are written judgments that we must pronounce on these individuals because this honor has all the sense. In other words, the other way of describing a restraining order is when we get to Matthew 16, 17 to 19, Jesus answered and said to Peter, "Blessed are you, Simon Barjona, for flesh and blood has not revealed this to you, but my Father in heaven." Now look at this. "I also say to you, Peter," this is the remnant church, "on this rock I'll build my governing council, and the gates of Hades shall not prevail against us." Now here is the keys to this restraining order. What did we say about restraining order? He says here, "I give you the keys of kingdom of heaven. Whatever you bind on earth shall be bound in heaven. Whatever you loose on earth will be loosed in heaven." So the situation that we find ourselves and this confusion that is in the political arena, we must accept the responsibility because it's us who either permit or it is us who is a restraint. And so this instrument is very, very important to remember that a restraining order is basically the same as binding on earth. And if you notice, then it shall be bound in heaven. When we lose on earth, it will be lost in heaven. But what is important in addition to recognizing our authority, we need to always remember our identity. Now, I'll take you to Revelations 5, 9 to 10. And they sang a new song, you are worthy to take the scroll to open its string, for you were slain and have redeemed us to God by your blood out of every tribe, tongue, and nation. Now look at this. And you have made us kings to manage the throne, to provide authority, and priests to maintain the altars to our God. And it says, and we shall reign. It doesn't say perhaps, maybe, probably, no. It says we shall reign. We shall execute. We shall restrain the kingdom of darkness. So what does this mean? So the first thing that we must do in terms of putting this into practice is we ask ourselves, we have people around our leadership on the continent with the following qualities. Sorcerers, I am sure all of you will agree with me that we have plenty who are seeking to turn the leadership of Africa from faith. They do not want the kingdom to advance. And we also have around our leaders men and women who are full of deceit, who are fraudsters, who basically for all practical purposes and intent are sons and daughters of the devil. Enemies of righteousness, who for every opportunity they have, they want to pervert the straight ways of the Lord. So now, if we have these individuals, the next question we ask is there a written judgment concerning these individuals? The Bible tells us, suffer not a witch to live. But even in this particular passage, the scripture tells us clearly that we can pronounce the judgment that the Apostle Paul pronounced upon this sorcerer. And that is that he was to be blind, not seeing the sun for a time. And God immediately responded. In the rest of it, as I already described, we saw what happened. Now, what we are going to do this evening, as I conclude, because I really want us to spend a lot more time issuing these restraining orders. But we will start by issuing a restraining order around our readership. Now, as I already mentioned, we need to understand that there are basic qualifications, just like in the courts of law. Not everybody can issue a restraining order. There are qualifications, there are things that make us qualify to actually do this particular exercise. So the first thing is that we should be dressed in the righteousness of our Lord Jesus Christ. Once we have done that, and whatever the Lord brings to our attention that needs to be dealt with in our lives, we deal with, because there's a way you approach any court, even human courts, we will then proceed together and pronounce. Now, I know that you may be struggling that are we not being too cruel if we start to issue orders that will have individuals get blind. That's why I said that the apostle was very messy. He said for a season that God should do in these sorcerers, these advisors that are blocking the work of God by having an influence over our president, ministers, our chiefs, our counselors, so that these individuals be saved and the kingdom of God expand. Now, I am using this for politics, but you could have a situation at work, as I'm sure Dr. Miles mentioned, then you should be able to go over this. So let me just, please, I'll read this restraining order for the entire continent. Let's be agreed together. So if you can switch on your, so that at the end, when I say amen, we will all agree together. So here goes the restraining order. God, the Father of our Lord Jesus Christ and our Father, we ask that you grant to us the meekness and gentleness of our Lord Jesus Christ as we stand in your heavenly court today. We bring before you the sorcerers, the advisors, the witches who have surrounded some of our presidents, ministers, chiefs, who are stopping our leaders in Africa who come to the knowledge of our Lord Jesus Christ and be saved. These sorcerers, oh Lord, are full of all deceit. They are fraudsters. They are sons of the devil. They are enemies of righteousness. They do not cease to pervert the straight ways of the Lord. On the basis of Psalm 149, verse 5 to 6, we pass the written judgment as follows. Let the hand of the Lord be upon the sorcerers, around president, ministers, chiefs, members, members of parliament, councillors. Let the sorcerers around the leadership in our countries on this continent be blind, not seeing the sun for a time in the name of Jesus.
Amen.
We declare and decree that let this action that will come from you lead to the salvation of our presidents, our ministers, our chiefs, our MPs, and our councillors. In Jesus' mighty name, we have decreed. Amen and amen.
Amen. Amen.
Yes. So this is where I am going to stop and then hand over. Is who am I supposed to hand over now? Is it Sister Naomi?
Bishop Boniface. No, she couldn't connect.
Bishop will take over. And clearly, we need to issue as many restraining orders against COVID-19, restraining orders against all the spiritual wickedness that is being brought up out of the abyss, restraining orders in all these particular areas. Dear brethren, this is our heritage as children of God. I have seen restraining orders work. But for today, let me stop here and hand over to Bishop Boniface. Bishop, please.
Praise the Lord. Doctor, I would like you to be able to handle the restraining order again for COVID, because this we cannot wait as well. And all the violence that could be around, you know, the nations in politics, particularly, yes. You know, in our nation, we are having elections this year, and we're also having Africa Unite Conference in Zambia this year. So this thing, I think, go ahead and let's try to.
So let's start with COVID. God, the Father of our Lord Jesus Christ, and our Father, we ask that you grant to us the meekness and gentleness of our Lord Jesus Christ as we stand in your heavenly court today. Yes. Dear Lord, we bring before you this pestilence called COVID-19. Yes. On the basis of Psalm 149, and Psalm 91, we pass the written judgment upon this pestilence. Mm. We thank you, mighty God, that you said in Isaiah 60 that there will be no violence or wasting in your land. Father, we stand on that decree, we stand on that scripture as we restrain this evil, a virus called COVID-19. For the entire continent of Africa, we release Almighty God, the virtue of healing, restoration, and the closure of any portals or gates that have been opened that have made us as a continent vulnerable to this COVID-19. We ask Almighty God in the name of Jesus Christ, yes, that you who is rich in mercies, you forgive all our iniquities and our transgressions. Mm-hmm. That Lord of mercy, let this virus be restrained on the continent, yes, of Africa. Let, yes, men and women know that there is a God in heaven who hears the prayers of the saints. Yes. Father, yes, we thank you. Father, we honor you. Father, we exalt your, mm-hmm, most excellent name. Yes. Father, we stand to restrain, mm-hmm, the violence, mm-hmm, that as we come before you in this your court, mm-hmm, We ask in the name of Jesus.
Yes.
Thank you, Lord, that you have made us kings and priests to rule on earth. Yes. Father, we thank you that you also taught us to pray that your will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Yes. You've also given us the keys to the kingdom. So, Father, we issue a restraining order from Cape to Cairo, from Mombasa to Dakar, that let there be no violence or wasting in the land in the mighty name of Jesus Christ, our Lord. We give you thanks, we give you praise, we give you glory. And now, dear Lord, we come before you also, that there are many of us, even in this platform at this moment, who the enemy has stolen things from. Father, let this year, as it is a year of restoration, a year of recovering all, we issue a restraining order against individuals, institutions, and even those that operate in magic arts that have stolen things from us. We issue that restraining order that let them return that which they have stolen from us, a sevenfold, as you have said in your word, that when a thief is caught, let him return a sevenfold. Let the joy be returned a sevenfold. Let righteousness be returned a sevenfold. Let the power be returned a sevenfold. Let healing be returned a sevenfold. Because we ask and plead all this, thanking you for making us acceptable in your court and making us acceptable, our words acceptable in your courts because of the finished work of our Lord Jesus Christ. For this we pray and ask and declare and decree. Let the restraining orders go forth according to the needs of every single nation represented on this platform, according to the needs of every single individual represented on this platform. Because we ask this in Jesus' mighty name, we prayed, amen.
Amen and amen. Amen. Praise the Lord. Amen. Oh, praise amen. The Lord. When something great is done, we just have to give the best of the praise and thanksgiving to the Lord, even before we get into Holy Communion. And I will ask Christine Lontaine, you're going to lead us into Holy Communion. You lead us into Holy Communion tonight. But before that, shall we all just lift our voices and lift up the name of the Lord and praise him and magnify the Lord and just thank him for what he has done tonight. Go ahead and just lift your voice.
Thank you.
Bless the name of
glorify your Lord.
Thank him.
Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Holy Spirit. Thank you for your grace and your mercy. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Lord, there is none like you. Hallelujah. We praise your holy name.
Thank you for what you have done in our country, thank you for what you have done in our continent,
worship you. We
Thank you, Lord Jesus.
The continent at large, mighty Father God, most mighty Father God, the authority that you've given us to tremble in serpents and scorpions, mighty Father God, and nothing indeed shall harm us, mighty Father God. Thank you that we are co-heirs with your Son, Jehovah God, in the precious mighty name of God.
The breakthrough in the political arena.
In the name of Jesus,
great is thy faith
across Africa, from Cape Town to Cairo, from Mombasa, oh God, to Cameroon. In Jesus' name.
Amen.
Amen.
Thank you, Lord.
Amen, Lord.
Thank you, Lord. And now, under 1 minute, may we all get our bread and our drink. The drink is the blood of Jesus. The bread is the body of Christ. As a Christine Lonte, please carry on and lead us into Holy Communion tonight. Thank you.
Yes. Father God, we just thank you that we can come before you tonight to celebrate the victory of our Lord Jesus Christ. To celebrate the reconciliation, Lord, that you have purchased for us, that you have made possible for us. For you are the image of the invisible God. You are the firstborn of all creation. And by you, all things have been created, Lord. And you are the head of the body, the church. You are the beginning, the firstborn from the dead, that in everything you might be preeminent. For Lord, in him, all the fullness of God was pleased to dwell, and through him to reconcile to himself all things, whether on earth or in heaven, making peace by the blood of the cross. And now, Lord, we who were once aliens and hostile in mind, doing evil deeds, you have now reconciled in your body of flesh by your death, in order to present us holy and blameless and above reproach before you. Thank you, Father God, for the wonderful gift of our salvation. Thank you, Jesus, for laying down your life for us. Thank you, Lord Jesus, that through your body we are healed. Through your wounds we are healed, Lord. By your blood we have been redeemed. And so, Lord, we would partake and participate in remembrance of this wonderful sacrifice that you've made for us, Lord. Thank you, Lord, that we are in you and you in us, and that this is an everlasting covenant that we celebrate, Lord. This is the new covenant in your blood. And so as we participate in your body and we eat this bread and we drink, Lord, the cup. We honor you and glorify you, and we stand up in that new life in which you've given us, the eternal life, which is an everlasting life, Lord. We thank you for your goodness and your grace in Jesus' name. So shall we take the bread? But I don't have mine with me. That's the problem. So I did forget to get that. So let's participate in the bread and thank the Lord for his body.
Amen.
Amen.
Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Lord, for your presence.
Thank you, Jesus.
We bless you and we honor you.
We do, yes.
Hallelujah. Shandala Baba.
Thank you, Jesus.
Thank you, Lord.
So, Lord, may we receive your peace. May you give us the peace of God. May the peace of God be with every one of us. May that shalom, that wholeness and completeness in him be with each one of us and strengthen us. Father, strengthen each one of us that are here together tonight, that we would be obedient in every way to you and honor and glorify your name in our lives, Lord. Thank you, Lord Jesus, for your holy presence with us forever and forever. Amen.
Praise the Lord. Have you told us to partake of the drink, Christy?
I beg your pardon. I'm so sorry. Let's drink
the wine. Have you told us to partake the drink, the blood of Jesus? I just heard you telling us to partake of the bread.
Okay, let's partake of the blood.
Amen. Exactly. Sure.
Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus.
Yes, thank you, Father. Yes, Lord. Yes, Lord. Yes, Lord.
The blood of Jesus speaks for me. Be still, my soul. For sinners slain, Jesus.
Hallelujah.
Praise the Lord. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Lord. I have a witness in my spirit that the Lord has done marvelous things tonight. And we shall be hearing great results. Great results. I like what Dr. Msiska also said, that Miriam was actually supposed to praise the Lord before they crossed the Red Sea. But she decided to praise the Lord on the other side after she had seen what the Lord had done. But the best place for us who are men and women of faith to praise the Lord is even before we are able to see. That is faith. And I'm glad that we have done this and the Lord is pleased with this. We shall see the end of Corona. We shall see the end of virus. We shall see the end of sorcerers. We shall see victory, and victory has come. Praise the Lord. Amanda, would you just wrap it up as we are coming to an end, woman of God? Thank you, Jesus.
Father, tonight I'm so touched by your love for your house, for the ecclesia, the governing body that you chose to bring your kingdom to earth, Lord God. And Father, tonight my deepest cry is that we will take our position, Lord, that we will take it serious, that we will reposition ourselves in Christ Jesus in heavenly places. Lord, that we will work with heaven to bring the kingdom of God to earth. I pray that you will minister to every fivefold minister on this continent, that you will visit us in our dreams, in open visions, in the night, in the day, Father, that yes, you yes. will bring the ecclesia
yes.
and reposition us in you. That you will not only activate, but empower through revelation knowledge.
Yes.
The remnant to take the position. And Father, I can see how your spirit move over this continent to strengthen the weak arms and legs, the feeble arms and legs, and how your spirit revive the dry bones, the dried out bones, and how the water, the living water, that is flowing from the throne of God and of the Lamb, come and revive the dried out bones. And we pray, our Father, let us take our position all over the continent. Bring yes. the remnant together. As the bones come alive, let us hear the voice Lord. Of God. Let us yes. come together Lord. In the spirit and in the physical. Yes. Let us yes. find the army. Let yes. us Lord. Take our positions in the army. Yes. Let us keep rank, Abba. And see the waves and waves upon waves of glory that you are releasing from heaven. Father, the waves that you have shown me in the dream, and you said it's 33 meters high waves, 30 meters high waves. And we pray, let glory come. And Lord, as you showed me in the dream, how the waves of beautifully golden covered glory waves came, flowing into homes. We pray, let the glory of God come. Let us become glory vessels unto you, releasing, releasing, releasing the waves into the harvest fields. And Lord, I can see it. I can see it and how it comes. Lord, it's like waves of wheat coming over the continent. And we pray, Abba, as we restrain, as your ecclesia, the evil works of Satan, we call forth, Lord, we pray that the threshing floor will be strengthened, that it will be strengthened, Abba. We call forth and we pray, thrash out more harvesters into your fields that's ripe and ready for harvest, Lord. Activate the evangelists, activate the pastors, the teachers, the prophets, the apostles, all over continent. Lord, let the fivefold take a place. Let the fivefold do what you was called to do. Let the mature bride come forth all over the continent of Africa. In Jesus' name, we call forth, Lord, the harvest and the harvesters. In Jesus' mighty name. Thank you for our leader, Dr. Nsispa. Thank you, Father, for the wisdom bestowed on him. Thank you for the impartation tonight, Lord. Let the seed of the word come to full fruition in us, Lord. Give us the spiritual capacity to receive and apply and to walk in the truth in Jesus' mighty name.
Jesus' mighty name.
Father, we come against the birds that wants to steal and destroy the seed. And we declare tonight that those who tune in, those who are on this platform, those who receive the word, are the 25% good soil. We declare it that none of this seed will fall on the wayside or the thorny grounds, but Lord, that it fell on good soil, that will bring forth the harvest.
Yes.
Jesus, mighty name. Right. Bless our leadership. Bless Bishop Boniface. Bless every intercessor. Lord, we pray. With very intimate times in your presence.
Yes.
Intimacy with you, Abba. We pray that you draw us into you.
Yes, Lord.
That we will live from a place of presence. Jesus, mighty name. Amen. Amen. Father, activate the gifts. Activate the gifts, Lord. In all of us. Let us walk in that authority. In Jesus' name. Amen. Amen.
Amen. Amen. Praise the Lord. Praise the Lord. Thank you, Jesus. Hallelujah. Wow. Just sense that presence of the Almighty God among us. Even as we go into our various rooms and where we are, may the presence of the Lord abide with us. The Lord himself abide with us. And may we keep this atmosphere, keep this temperature, keep this presence of the Almighty God and treasure this so very much. We'll meet on Saturday. 8 hours, all of you, and invite others. And now may the Lord bless you and keep you. May the Lord make his face to shine on you. May the Lord lift his countenance towards you, and the Lord give you peace, the shalom, in Jesus' name. Amen and amen.
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 On behalf of Dr. Msiska, Naomi, and Amen. Amanda, and all
Amen.
Of you,
Amen.
The Lord bless you. Shalom, shalom.
You and a blessed day.
Bless you.
Shalom.